Perfect. What's up, people? I'm Hansley Gonzalez here, and this is another, what would you call this? What's that?
A special episode.
A special episode. So, we are here with my buddy's boat, as you guys seen it already. You know, beautiful Sea Hunt BX24BR with a beautiful wrap, America. So, apparently, his jack plate is not working anymore. So whenever he hits the button, let me show you guys here. I don't know, can you guys hear that noise? It's like a statically electrical noise. It looks like the relays, it's a module relay, it's done deal, so it needs to be replaced. So we're gonna show you guys how to replace those relays. We're gonna show you guys where those relays are in this boat. I'm assuming they're all the same when it comes to this model. So this is what we're talking about here, folks. So, oh, by the way, we're working with the Atlas jack plate. That's the brand. And this is the relay module here. This is the new one right here. So you guys see, they got a couple relays. They're inside this encased seal. So everything is, you know, you got a fuse over here. You got a couple wires, power and ground and stuff like that. So this right here costs about what, 130, you said? Oh, I'm sorry, I was way off. $205. But for those who uses the jack plate, you know, it's paramount to have this. So, all right, let's get going here. All right, guys, so back here on this platform, on this boat, you got two access to the bilge, that one over there, and then you have one in the middle. So this is where those relays are located, right there. You see that module right there? So you got all the wires and stuff like that. So we're gonna replace those. There's a bunch of wires. So, but that's where it's located for those who had the BX24 Sea Hunt. Okay, so let's get to it. So you unplugging the power.
These are the up and the down for the jack plate.
Up and down, okay.
Up and down, I gotta locate the red. Positive okay. In the ground.
Okay.
Which is right here. I gotta trace them back to the battery, disconnect those, and then okay. I've got some more wires.
So those cables that go straight to the battery, right? The positive and the red?
Yes.
Okay.
I believe they go to the power switch when you turn it on.
Okay. All right. Perfect. So you're gonna have to trace them all the way to the switch on the front?
Yes.
Oh, that's not gonna be fun. Can you just use the existing wires and?
You can use the existing wires up until this here, and then you're gonna reconnect them into here. So you gotta find out where they are and go to here.
So these ones are the one that goes all the way to the switch?
No, the positive and the negative.
Gotcha.
I believe this one here is the positive. I just gotta retrace it better right here.
Okay.
And it goes to the switch.
Oh, to the battery switch. Oh, okay, perfect. I thought I was thinking the actual switch on the dashboard over there.
Nah.
Okay, that's not too bad at all.
Hopefully not.
All right, perfect. Folks, so some of that wiring is going inside the switch right there. He just took off. There you go. So he's going to have to disconnect that from the back of the switch. Oh, the one on the bottom? go figure. All right. So these ones are already, okay. So these ones are already spliced up. This one already got the, well, let's do this. let me give you the new one.
Hold on, I'm gonna wait until the end. box.
The black one?
Yeah, the small black one.
By the way, guys, this is the part numbers over here for the relays. So got it right there. I will put a description on the video on where to get them to. So out with the old. Here it is, old one. So we just had to, since this one come like this, we just have to cut the existing cable that goes all the way to the actual switch, and we're gonna splice it up, and we're gonna tie them up together. Okay, so we're gonna splice up the these wires right here, so we can connect them. About three of them, so this is probably the hardest part of the whole thing because everything else is already pre-done. So battery, negative, positive, connectors go to the jack plate. And that's about it. So the males that goes inside here from the jack plate, every once in a while, like those right there, you see, every once in a while they'll get corroded. So you might want to get, check that first. If, all of a sudden the jack plate doesn't work, and just get some thin, you know, maybe like, maybe 220 sandpaper, and just, you know, sand them really good. That way you can get all the corrosion out of there. Put some dielectric silicone, or I don't remember what was the other stuff that you bought, but
dielectric grease,
there you go. And it works that way, prevent from all of that. It prevents from moisture to get inside here, you know. Once moisture sits in there, and especially salt water, it starts creating a corrosion. So it's always good to just put a dab of that stuff in there if you're already doing it. So make sure you matched up all the colors to the right. They're too small.
Yeah.
I'll put it in the. Put it on the other side.
Yeah,
don't
no,
it?
But I need it to go over that when we get done. So
I see. Do we have? We didn't buy the other ones. Do we? It was only one pack that we got.
We only bought one pack. You don't have any extra laying around, do you?
No, I don't. I don't. So we were gonna put some heat shrink tube just to go the extra mile to just prevent from those connectors to get corroded. Just extra protection. But the ones we got from Ace the other day, they were a little too thin. I can't believe that doesn't fit in there. Huh. All right. So pretty much, folks, like every other connector, you just want to match the cables to it by color. And just pretty much cramp them. Yeah, that one, the cramp is on the back. Make sure it's nice and tight. Any wiggling on the wires, it'll create a every once in a while something not work properly. So you want to make sure that it's clamped on there really nice and tight, because folks, we're moving on the boat, and doesn't matter if we're getting a lot of waves. It's just eventually, just with a little vibration, little by little, it'll come loose. So there you go. There you go.
Let me do that for you, buddy.
Put some power in that grip. There you go. Nope. All right.
We're gonna let a real person do this. We'll be back.
All right, folks. So this is the dielectric grease that we were talking about. I will also put a link in this video so you guys can go straight and buy this where we bought it from. So once again, I'm gonna throw a dab in here of this beautiful stuff. Maybe a couple drops. Yep, one there, two there. Couple of there. Couple of there. Excellent. So, nope. So, stick them in there. There you go. That's all there is to it, folks. If you have a little bit of residue, leave it on there. It doesn't hurt anything. It won't hurt anything. So, in fact, it'll coat, you know, all this stuff right here. So, all right. Well, this is the moment of truth there, Captain. Let's see if this thing starts working. Once again, this is the Atlas. Oh, look at that. What do you know? What do you know? We must have done something right, so. There you go. Perfect, perfect, guys. So there you have it. Once again, the relay modules on these things, you know, and they sit back there on the boat. So everything in here starts gets humid. This is a 2014 boat, and so 10 years already. I think that's pretty good. That's pretty darn good for switches and stuff like that to last that long. So anyhow, once again, I hope you like my video. Please click the notification bell and like if you like the video. Subscribe to my channel once again. Here's Captain Aaron right here. Once again, folks, thank you for watching the channel, and we'll see you in the next episode. Goodbye.